we have to define a role. Very clearly, we have to define a role.
Just this year, we have almost two projects that are going to support TVET. Going into next year, we have the 20 State of the Art, which is going to run into about 350, and other ones we intend to establish district TVET centers that will be more localized.
When we talk about diversity, people see it bringing in women. It's also a discussion of bringing in men. I've been to a hairdresser's place where there were all women, and when a guy joins, they ridicule the guy. So this discussion is not about guys saying women come in, it's women also saying guys come in. So in my team now, I'm trying to bring in some extra guys to come and support the thing work.
Understanding that mathematics is the underlying, or gives us the underlying fundamentals that can then create technology.
Also personnel, how to run that school. So without government and without this institution, the school would not exist. And knowledge here that technical development contributed a lot towards the progress of the world, but also towards the destruction of the world, especially.
Well, it's good to have you here, because right now we have only representatives here from the private sector, from the credit unions and from the church. And we are talking and discussing about technical and vocational education and training, and what role the government and what role the private sector has to play.
TVET education, my dear brothers and sisters, does not start when you are 15 or 20 years old. I tell you. Sorry that I will refer to myself. I was a little kid. TVET starts from when you are small, when you learn how to crawl, not walk, how to learn how to crawl. Mentality grows from when you are very little, boy or girl. That is number one. Number two is the last one, the key. So that is the first key, what I see a challenge for me. The second key, I want to be well understood. Don Bosco, for example, technical institute that I represent, Don Bosco Mondo, we need government, and we thank here, I think government is cooperating with us, especially in Sunyani, and we need industry. What government has to do, what Don Bosco has to do, and what the industry has to do. We as Don Bosco, we have educative system, very well, very good, working very well for the past 150 years, no doubt at all. So we have our own system, and I want my system to be respected, because we are here for young people, for the good of the country, wherever we find Don Bosco. And the industry is our backbone. Without the industry, we cannot also worry because we need to send our students.
We must mentor them. They must be mentored. Without people to look up to, it's difficult to make young people say, see that I want to be a plumber. Because he sees a plumber, very dirty guy, going around all the time. And his house, he cannot even provide food for himself.
We learned more about how to start our business and how to earn money.
As I'm going back, I'm going to teach my people, my colleagues, how to save money for our future years.
Tools we use are going to inform the standards we set as far as training, delivery, and productivity is concerned.
Many companies are working, except those companies are exporting and per EU standards and the rest. We need to go with that. So if we really want to come out clearly, we need to make sure that most of our trainees and the rest work in hand with the ISO standards. And the ISO standards will guide you to be competitive.
If we know that even with the informal sector, people go out to the market to buy tools, and they prefer to buy used tools, to buy new tools, because people are always suspicious of the new ones. Companies like us are here to ensure that you get the best tools.
So the key thing is that you, the companies, have to take the leadership. Well, the people they are training for you. They are going to work for you, they are going to destroy your thing, they are going to create the cost for you, they are going to do everything for you. So it is your part of your responsibility to partner with the training institutions to ensure that they are delivering quality training. Corporate can be there as a regulator to ensure you don't abuse the system, but corporate or the government should not interfere in training. The training should be led by the private sector, should be led by the companies, because they know better what they want. They know better the kind of skill they want, the kind of competencies you know better.
Congratulate and thank organizers of Educata that they have planned and they were bold enough to move so many people, especially young people, to participate during this event. So this is how I would see a way forward. Together with intellectual development, we need to develop this technical development in order to progress as other countries do.